So we'll do some, we'll do half fresh. Let's get these in here without spilling them. And we'll roast these off quickly. Just flip them in the pan a bit. There's nothing better than roasted nuts. Nuts taste 20 times better once they've had a little heat added. You know what's really good about this paper? Like, the fish needs to be sort of drier anyway.
That's beetroot leaves.
Beetroot leaves.
Cucumber. Sweet. I'm going to put some avocado and some fresh tomatoes in that and make a wasabi dressing.
Cool.
What is this game?
Look at this. This is fascinating.
I think the reason why I'm doing the catch and cooks like this is just I just want to show that, like, when I go fishing, it's not all about, you know, snagging big fish and just bragging rights. It's about catching fish for food and coming home and then sharing it with, like, my family. So basically we've cut up some tuna already. You can see this strip was actually the really nice strip that was actually perfectly formed and I cut up properly. The rest are actually just the off cuts. But you don't want to waste anything, so we're eating the offcuts here in these two strips. And then we're going to move across to these as well. We're going to sear them just very lightly with sesame seeds and salt and pepper. So we'll get into that. And then we've got everything else set up. We've also got the salad that he's just brought over. And that's looking delicious. I think you saw some of that getting prepared already. But that's going to be the accompaniment tonight, so that's really, really good. Tuan just said, unfortunately we've forgotten the ginger, so we're not having ginger with the tuna tonight, but when everything else is looking this good, it really doesn't matter. Yeah. So it's certainly not just me doing the cooking when I get home and catch these fish, It really it makes a big difference just to get helpers, and especially when I bring a big fish to, this is my mother-in-law's, Lee's. She's actually doing the helping here, so she's rolling it in the salt and pepper. And then rolling in the sesame seeds. So we pre-roasted the sesame seeds in the pan. And the problem is when you're searing it, because you're only searing for, you know, maybe 20 seconds tops, the sesame seeds don't have enough time to heat up enough to really become tasty. So roast them first, roll it, and then cook again, and it'll just become so much tastier. All right, now we're gone. So once that heats up, we want it nice and hot. So basically, as soon as we chuck them on, we're searing straight away. Put a bit of oil in the pan at the end. We should be able to do them all at once. Just a little bit of oil. There's no need to go crazy. We're not deep frying. We just want enough oil to coat the pan so it doesn't stick. Alright, so we're doing a quick sear. Literally, when you're flipping it and when you're doing it, you really only want to sear them for maybe, like, let's say 20 to 30 seconds. Just a few mils in on each side. Okay, onto the chopping board, and then we'll put them on the nice board. So ideally, when we come down, see, this one's looking ideal. Because I'm talking and mucking around, see, this one is not looking so great. I've gone too far, but it'll be fine. Once we get actually further in, it'll actually come good. But you just want a few mils in on each side. You don't want to sear it too much. The searing is just to give a little bit of heat. Get the outside crust going, and the rest of the tuna should actually be quite raw, and that's what's really going to taste the best. So hopefully you don't go as far as I just went then. When we cut down, just do thin slices, but support the meat around it. You don't want all the seared parts to fall off, so just support it with your fingers. Do your best to cut it straight down. And a nice sharp knife is really key here. So sorry if this catch and cook all sort of seemed a bit hectic, but that's what I sort of really wanted to show, you know, the fact that I come home and I don't just, you know, cook in a sterile environment. It's all about the family. We come home, we all get together, we eat it together, and that's all part of the fun. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you see some tuna, and yeah, we'll get some hero shots of the tuna from this point on. Thanks, Dash.